My dear friend, you are welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to practically show how to replace a contactor coil. Alright, so this is a contactor, and the contactor has a coil. It is this coil that gets magnetized to close the contacts of the contactor to the load. Alright, when the coil goes bad, you can easily replace the coil. But then, there is no one standard voltage for contactor coils. The contactor coil can be designed to work on 220 volts like this one, but there are others that also work on 120 volts and then 400 volts AC. There are also contactor coils that will only work on 12 volts DC, and there are others that will work on 24 volts DC. So before you think of replacing the coil, you first of all have to know what voltage will energize that particular coil. Or, before you replace the coil, you also have to be mindful of the available supply to energize the coil. In the same way, you can also decide to change the coil of a particular contactor depending on the supply available to you to energize the coil. So now, to change the coil is very simple. There is a place around the contactor where you can open the contactor to get access to the coil. So we have this one screw, and then there is another one at the other side here. Okay, so first of all, you open the contactor by removing these screws, and then we remove the one at the other side. So this is the coil lying at the base of the contactor, and this is how the coil looks like. If current flows through these terminals to the coil, a magnetic field is created around the coil, which causes this iron core to be magnetized to attract this iron core at the top to itself. Alright, so when the coil gets energized, this iron core becomes magnetized and forces to attract this one at the top to itself. And then when that happens, the contacts close between the input and then the output. So now we are going to replace this coil. All right, so we can replace this coil based on several factors. One, we will have to replace it when it goes bad, when it burns off, or when it's not functioning again. And we can also replace it because we want a particular voltage rating. So assuming this contactor comes with a 220 volt coil, but where I am installing it, I only have three phase available. And so I can replace this coil with a coil that can be energized by 400 volts. So here, I am replacing this one with this one. And also, depending on the size of the contactor, the coils come in different shapes and different sizes. So when you want to replace a contactor, it's best you have to do well to get the same size, as the one you are replacing. So here, I have the same size of the coil that I'm going to replace. So you set it just as the previous one, and then you close it back. Then the last screw comes here. Thank you very much for watching, and please, if you have benefited from watching this video, kindly hit the like button, share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe in case you have not yet done that. See you in my next video. Stay connected.